You're thinking about a data analyst career, and everywhere you look, you see the words project and portfolio. But what is a project and portfolio, and why do you need one? As someone who's been a hiring manager for data analysts, I'll be going over what a data project is and how to create one that employers are actually looking for. First off, what is a data analyst project and why do you need one? Imagine you're applying for a job as a gardener. It's not enough to simply say you love plants and you have gardening tools. You want to actually showcase your skills, and employers will be looking for you to demonstrate your gardening abilities. Just as a gardener will showcase their well-maintained garden, a data analyst will showcase their data analysis skills through a project. So when you're applying for a job as a data analyst, you're inviting the employer to look through your projects and see firsthand that you have data analysis skills for the role. And to explain projects simply, there are three steps involved. The first step is data set and objective. The best projects I've seen are the ones with real use cases and real stakeholders, because that is the closest you'll get to having work experience. That includes volunteering, freelancing, or figuring out how you can somehow use data analysis on the job, because all that would be still considered work experience. Now, if you don't have any of those opportunities, a great way is to use online data sets that are readily available, and one that I recommend is Kaggle. Kaggle is a free resource where you can download data sets across many different domains. Now, what kind of data should you choose? I would recommend that you choose a data set relevant to the industry that you're interested in working for. So if I wanted to be a healthcare data analyst, I would choose a data set related to healthcare rather than a sports analysis, which is not relevant to the type of industry that I want to work in. And choosing a project that's related to the industry I want to work towards not only showcases my data analysis skills, but also the fact that I'm interested in it as well. Now that we have the data set, before we do any analysis, the first thing we want to do is define the objective. By that, I mean, why are you doing the analysis and what are you trying to solve for with the data? The objective is going to define your project from start to finish. And an example is if I'm using this healthcare data insurance data set and I have the following information like age, gender, and charges, I could do an analysis where I determine the factors that influence charges and then make a recommendation on how to lower costs. Now that I have the data and objective defined, we're ready for step two, which is the data analysis. Most likely, the first step in data analysis is going to be data cleaning, and that just means you're going to look at the formatting, make sure the dates are in date formats, the currencies are all in the same currency, maybe dollars, and look for any inconsistencies that you want to clean up before your analysis, because bad data means that your analysis will be bad as well. After the data is clean, now you'll work on the actual analysis of the data, and that can include exploratory data analysis, descriptive analysis, maybe some model building. Basically, you want to choose the analytical method that solves your problem from the objective you defined. The data analysis step is really where you're going to highlight your technical skills and your analytical problem solving. Technical skills used here include Excel, SQL, a BI visualization, and/or Python. And it doesn't have to be all of these. I would say maybe one or a combination of them would be good. And if you need some help, I have a dedicated video where I go through a data analyst project that you would in tech. So I'll link that video for your reference. Once you've done your analysis, we now move on to step three, present your findings. This is where your communication skills will shine, and you'll want to document your work by writing a narrative that includes the objective, your findings, your data analysis steps, as well as any recommendations or lessons learned. Here are some examples where you can see that they have the narrative really laid out. They have the objective and problem at the top and go through their data analysis steps and the insights. You can see there really isn't a standard of how to present your data, but you want to make sure that you're storytelling with your data, that you're including some of your findings with visuals throughout your narrative, and also that you are keeping your audience in mind, which is the recruiter who is non-technical. So you want to make sure that you're communicating really simply and easily to your audience. Hiring managers and recruiters are ultimately interested in whether you can draw insights out of data and present it. And that's why you want to make sure that you are documenting your work in your project. And if you're interested in other skills that are required for data analysts, then make sure you are subscribed to the channel, as I will be doing another video on the data analyst career. Now, you understand that presenting your project is important, but where do you present it? There isn't a specific place to put your projects for presentation, but there are four common places that I will go over, and you want to just make sure that whichever one you choose, that it is public and readily available for any recruiter to see. My first pick is GitHub, which is an open source repository where developers will store and share the code. This is a great place where you can include your narrative, your documentation, your code, and even visualizations. And it really keeps everything in one place so that you can share it with recruiters. The next is Tableau Public, which is public, free, and interactive. This would allow the audience to be able to see your dashboard fully, as well as any of the insights that you were able to draw. And the next is Kaggle, which is very similar to GitHub. It's a repository. You can share your code, your narrative, and also if you participate in any competitions, that would be available on your Kaggle profile as well. Or a personal website or blog is another place you can share your projects, and this would allow you to have more control over how you're showing your projects. But depending on which platform you're using, this may require some code as well as a cost to it. Whichever platform you choose, there are two places you definitely want to share your project, and the first is on your LinkedIn profile. Under your LinkedIn profile, there's a link where you can share projects. You can also add it under your work experience, as well as making posts to share the good work you did and make yourself more visible to recruiters. And the second place you want to show your projects is on your resume. This is so important because your projects are done in place of work experience, and this is where you'll want to showcase all your data analysis skills. Now, I'll be honest, the recruiter may not even end up clicking the link and actually seeing the code and the visualizations you put together, but they will read your resume. So you want to make sure that the bullet points, that the way you're adding the project section on your resume really stands out. And I have a whole video on how to add projects to a data analyst resume, which is a great next step for this video. So I will link it, and I can't wait to see you there.